I'll get them back on in a minute. Oh dear, sorry, we're a little bit late starting. The rain. Does anyone need a copy of the set list for tonight? I won't be able to see you if you put your hands up anyway. I can. Yeah?
Yeah? Thank you.
Margaret will have the other ones if you don't. And we're going to start off the first 25 minutes or so with our ukulele chord progressions sheet. Is that what I sent out? I think it is.
Yeah.
So anyone need a copy of that?
Yeah.
And see. Very good. Now, before we get to it, you will see on the set list that we've got upside down twice. It's an old set list that I've kind of changed some bits and pieces. I've got to change that error on it. So don't. Yeah. Don't convey the email and reminded me. We can do it twice, it's nice. We'll do it two different ways, is what we'll do. Now, just check. Joan, can you hear me on Zoom okay? Yeah, brilliant, good. And YouTube, we can see. So, we need this ukulele chord progressions 1 sheet, to show the people on the internet. There we go. Hopefully, you got that in front of you. Oops, sorry. And these chord progressions are like, they're like a broken down song. So they're like a song if we take away the lyrics, the words, the rhythm, the tempo, the kind of the melody, the tune. And what we've got left are the chords. And that's really useful then for practicing. We can do finger picking, strumming, different rhythms, different time signatures, whatever we want. Okay, so this first one, because we've done these loads before, what we're going to do is this. We're going to do 8 quick strums like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right? And then second fret. You can use your thumb or fingernail or whatever you want, okay? Just 8 quick strums, then change second fret, first fret, second fret, third fret. So C, C major 7, C 7, C major 7, back to C. 1, 2, 3, 8 strums. Second fret, first fret, second fret, third fret, second fret, first, second, C, C major 7, C 7, C major 7, and 1 strum, C. Good, excellent, nice. Sounds a little bit James Bondish, doesn't it? Very good. Okay. Let's try this. Same chord progression. We're gonna give it a fancy strum. Down, down, up, down, up, down, down. Down, down, up, down, up, down, down. So third fret and down. Second fret. Go to number 2. Same again. 8 quick strums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A minor. Okay. Now we'll slow it down a little bit. 8 strums, not as fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Change. Okay. And remember, when you get to the G, you can do a G or a G7. Either works fine. Okay. A bit slower. 8 strums. Number 2. C, A minor, F, and G or G7. 2, 3, C. Good, 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 good. Okay, the fancy strum, down, down, up, down, up, down, down. Number two still. One, two, three, C. A minor. Style number two, we're going to do offbeat. One, two, three, four, change. One, two, three, four, change. One, two, just four strums, change. One, C. One, two, three, C. One, two, three, A minor. One, two, three, F. One, two, three, G. One, two, back to C. One, two, three, A minor. One, two, three, F. One, two, three, G or G7, two, four strums to C, one, two, three, stop. Good, excellent. Now, let's try that again. This time we're gonna go, let's just do a down up. Okay, down up, real quick, da-da, okay? One, da-da, two, da-da, three, da-da, four. Da-da, okay, from the C, one, two, three, down up. Two, three, A minor. One, two, three, F. One, two, three, G. C. A minor. F. G or G7. C. Finish. One, two, three, stop. Good. Excellent. Excellent. Now, just say with that one there, we can, well, with all of these, our strumming, and John will get this, all we're trying to do is release the inner diva, right? And our dancers over there and over there will know what I'm talking about. When you're dancing, I didn't dance, when I watch dancing, it's like that's got to come from within. You can't just be externally talked about. You've got to have that sense of rhythm. And that's what we're trying to bring out of ourselves, is a sense of rhythm. So we're not counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, but we're just feeling the kind of rhythm. That 1, 2, 3, 4, that kind of runs through a lot of our music, most of our music. We can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and like that. So we're trying to feel it, let that inner rhythm diva rise from within, or for John, a rhythm dragon, maybe. So just try and feel it, so we're not thinking about it so much. Good. Okay, let's go number three. G, G major 7, G 7, G major 7. Okay. Four strums. From the G. One, two, three on the beat down. One, two, three. G major 7. G 7. G major 7. Back to G. G major 7. G 7. G major 7. Back to G. Four strums. Five strums. Three, four, five. Good. Okay, let's do it again. This time we'll do the fancy strum, but slow it down. This chord progression is a kind of a thoughtful chord progression. It's kind of like, it's not going anywhere on the journey very much. It's just, is that what they call that guitar? Isn't it? Yeah. That you can let them just dry it off. They're going to play it as a song. So, it's not really going anywhere. It's kind of just going around in gentle circles. It's kind of like a lazy Sunday afternoon. So from the G, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, down, down, up, down, up, down, G major 7, down, down, up, down, up, down, G7, G major 7, do, 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 G, ba, 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 G major 7, da, 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 G7, ra, ba, 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 and one strum of G. Good, nice. So we can give the chord progressions kind of different feelings, different meanings, take them on different journeys, depending on how we do it. If we do that eight strums, it's a sense of urgency to it. It's kind of like, wait, rushing to get there. It isn't, which is just going for a little Sunday afternoon drive. The streets of Alveson. Very nice. Good. Good. Excellent. Alright. Let's try the next one, number four, G, E minor, C and D. Now, this E minor, we've got four dots on the E minor, so four fingers, but we don't need to do four fingers. It sounds exactly the same if you do three fingers. So you just put your fingers on the bottom three strings and just leave the top one open. If you wanted it even easier, you could do an E minor seventh and just do a G and take the third finger off, E minor seventh. And that would work fine as well. Always substitute E minor for E minor 7, but in the key of G, it's absolutely fine to do so. So, four strums, nice and slow, number four from the G. One, two, three from the G, and E minor, C, D, at the end of each kind of chord, the end of each four beats. So like this. Up, down, up, down, up. Da, 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 da. So one, like this. One, two, three, da, 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 da. That kind of thing. And it doesn't need to be exact. It's not a science, it's an art form. So it's just something that gives that sense of kind of movement, of moving into this chord, okay? One, two, three, da, 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 da. Okay, from the G. One, two, three, G, and here we go. Da, 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 E minor. Da, 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 C. You've got to think about your chord changes at the same time as doing that little fancy strum. G. Related to the music that we play them along to. Doo-wop. Doo-wop. As John said there, doo-wop chord progression. So doo-wop. Now, in order to make it sound doo-wop-ish, we could do this strum. Down, down, up, and then change. Thank you. down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down. From the G, here we go. G, E minor, C, and D. G, E minor, C, and D. Bum, 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 bum. Okay, pause there. Good. Okay, now we'll try that, and the fourth time through, we're going to do one strum of the D, and pause, and then go back to the G again. You'll get it. When you play it, you'll be like, oh yeah, I know what you mean by that, okay? So four times through, on the fourth time, we're going to hit the D once, stop, and then get back on the G again, okay? From the D, one, two, three, sorry, from the G, one, two, three, four. Takes on a little journey, very nice indeed. Okay, we did some finger picking before, so let's just try and do some finger picking with some of these chord progressions. Let's start back on number one again, and let's do we'll do a guitar style, thumb and three fingers on the top string pointing down, three fingers on the next three strings pointing up. Okay, so it's guitar style. Thumb on the top string resting, looking down. Three fingers, one inch string resting below the strings, looking up at the thumb. Fingers kind of curl round. We're going to go thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger. Put them all back on again. Thumb, one, two, three. Thumb, one, two, three. Good. We're going to go from the C chord. Ready? C, two, three. Down the C, change to C major 7, 2nd fret. Thumb 1, 2, 3, 1st fret. Back to the 2nd fret. Back to the 3rd fret, C. C major 7. Make sure you don't change until after 1, 2, 3, change. First fret. 1, 2, 3, second fret. One strum of C, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good, excellent. Okay, let's try that with the second chord progression. C, A minor. So we'll do two patterns. Thumb one, two, three. Thumb one, two, three. Change. Okay? No pauses in between. So now what we're trying to do is to separate our left hand and our right hand so that the left hand is independent to the right hand and they can just do their own thing without having to worry about each other. So think about your right hand, thumb one, two, three, thumb one, two, three. And just let that keep going. And then think about your chord changes and then you can start thinking about what you're going to do this weekend or something in the rain. Okay, so it's number two, C, A minor, F, G, two patterns of each, thumb one, two, three, thumb one, two, three. Five, six, seven, C, and thumb one, two, three. A minor. F. Make sure you don't change until the end of the pattern, G, or G7, C. A minor, F, G or G7, C strum, one strum, good, Nice. Excellent. So hopefully you understand what I mean by kind of separating the left hand and the right hand. I know that it's a little bit of a daft way of saying it, but you've really got to allow your right hand to start playing that pattern. And if we're doing that pattern, thumb 1, 2, 3, that's what we're doing. We're not doing anything different. It's not deviating from that. It's not pausing. It's not stopping. If the left hand can't change chord, the right hand doesn't need to worry about that. It says, don't fret. That's a ukulele trick. It works with guitar. The right hand shouldn't be stopping just because the left hand is worrying about the chord change coming up or fumbles the chord change. Gets it wrong. The right hand carries on going. It didn't even know the left hand went wrong. Okay, that is what we're after. Okay, so thumb 1, 2, 3, thumb 1, 2, 3, keep going. Let's do number 3, G, G major 7, G7, G major 7. Two patterns of each, okay? We're going to go slower, so we'll do it a couple of times, and then we're going to do one pattern of each, then change chord. Okay, so number 3, G, G major 7, G7, G major 7, back to G. 1, 2, 3, G. G major 7. So two patterns. G7. G major 7. Back to G. G major 7. G7. G major 7. One pattern of each. G. G major 7. G7. G major 7. G. G major 7. It went a bit quiet. G7. G major 7. One strum of G. Good. Okay, it's difficult, isn't it? Your right hand was, if it's like mine, start to make mistakes. But why is that? You know, because your right hand doesn't need to worry about the left hand, but it's because we haven't separated them out. Our brain is one brain, and we're thinking about them both, not independently, but we're thinking about them kind of like, oh, I'm getting this wrong, and the right hand's getting nervous. It doesn't need to. The right hand just needs to go thumb, 1, 2, 3. We've been doing it for the last couple of minutes. So no reason that should go wrong, just... That's why we practice the finger picking, is because we want to devote as little brain capacity, and Jonathan's ears pricked up at that, as little brain capacity, Jacob, as little brain capacity as possible to the right hand, okay? The right hand, if it's strumming, the rhythm's coming from within, it's not a brain thing. If we're finger picking, it's a simple pattern. Thumb, 1, 2, 3. Once we've got that kind of locked in, then we can devote very, very little kind of brain power, if you like, brain capacity to that. It just needs motor functions. Thumb, 1, 2, 3. Keep the hand nice and steady. Remember, you can anchor it on the front of the ukulele if you want to or whatever. Just keep that going, practice it, and eventually you won't have to think about it. And then you can think about your chord changes. And if it's more difficult, the right hand still keeps going, the left hand can change chords. Okay, let's do that again. G, G major 7, G7, G major 7. Number 3, thumb 1, 2, 3, change. A bit slower for you, okay? 5, 6, 7, G. G major 7. G7. G major 7. G. G major 7. G7. G major 7. G. One more time. G major 7. G7. G major 7. One strum of G. So there's the thing to practice this week, okay? Give that a go. Now you can be forgiving on yourselves. You can do it 4 times, then pause, change chord, restart the pattern. But that's not like a song would be. You don't pause in the middle of a song to change chord. That'd be a rubbish gig. People want their money back for sure. And we don't do money back. So, but start off like that. Be forgiving. Slow it down. Do 4 times the pattern. It shouldn't make it easier, but it means there's less kind of rush on the left hand changing chord. So do it 4 times, pause, change chord, restart, thumb 1, 2, 3, 4 times, pause, change chord. Then try and either do it 2 times, pause, or take the pause out, do it 4 times and jump straight into the next chord. Okay, just make it more difficult for yourself until you're doing one pattern change, and so on. Okay, very good indeed. All right, well, it's 6 o'clock. It's 6 o'clock, we should get on with our set list. Set list is on the website, www.ukulelejam.co.uk. But Lisa, on her second visit at the back there. That's sitting in Jeff's seat. Jeff, you chose to sit there because you used to always sit there. But he's closer to the action. You can tell when people are feeling more confident, they get closer to the front. I mean, look at John. He's right there. Starts you right there. Jeff's getting closer and closer. Give it a year, Jeff's going to be here. Give it 2 years, Jeff's going to be up here.
I'll be outside.
Yeah. I'll be in the street.
Very good.
All right. So we've got set this here, like Margaret's got set this if you need them. Great to have Mike back, who's not been here for a few weeks, he's been unwell, so good to have you back. There's other people unwell at the moment, so that's why they're not here.
Thanks, Dan, we both had COVID.
Jojo as well. You wouldn't have thought, Jojo, that I would have missed you, definitely. But, right. Tell you what I think. I'm just going to buy a drink. Back in a second. What at the front of the class as well. Yeah, basically, yeah, you get more and more confident, you move further forward, and eventually you find yourself in the wheat sheet. Okay, 59th Street Bridge song. Malcolm texted me, he's unwell, but hope to be back next week. Lisa, you've not been here when we've had bass. This makes a lot of difference. That's just in case he's watching on YouTube. That is true. So, songbook 1, page 24, 59th Street Bridge song.
Drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time come.
see some feeling moving. Yeah, very good. All right. Now let me just show you a quick thing on this one, because basically we've got upside down twice on the set list, so we're going to have to pad it out a little bit. Now, when we get to the third verse, I got no deeds to do, no promises to keep. We do this kind of funny rhythmic thing. Yeah, I have to do it. The kind of the rhythm of the song's not changing, the time signature. Dun, dun, ka, dun, dun, ka, dun, dun, ka, dun, all the way through. But we can change our strumming, which some of us are doing, on the dappled and drowsy. And all we're doing is this. It's really just down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. That was all, it's just down, up. But it's kind of going against rhythm. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you. So give that one go, okay? So it's on the dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. And then back into the dum, da ka dum, da dum, da ka dum. Okay? 1, 2, 3. I got no deeds to do, no promise. Here go. 3, 4. Ba 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 ba. Ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you. Young Ones by Cliff Richard, songbook 9, page 26. I'll ask Ben, is it waiter service, Ben, or do I have to come and get it? Oh, Ben's coming up to the front. Let's see if we can get to sing some. Did she? As he jacks disappeared. I saw him earlier and some areas started running off. It's Ben, everybody.
Ben.
Things in life come and go. Ben is a constant. Thanks, Ben.
I am, yeah.
Yeah, he is. He's still not singing. Adam. Oh, Alan.
Hi.
Alan's here. So make an entrance, Alan. Why don't you? I'm sure you played it around. The Young Ones by Cliff Richard in F. Oh, here's a shout out to my father-in-law, Pete, who's watching. He's not watching until Saturday morning, but you understand that for him this was seen live. So he said a very funny thing the other day. I used a name that we used to call him when I first met him, sort of thing. And he misheard me and thought I said Cliff Richard. So we'll dedicate this to him. It made us laugh at the time, it's not funny now, but we'll dedicate this to my good friend and father-in-law, Pete Dormer, to know what we're doing. When you get these song sheets, if this was a new song, it doesn't, if you didn't know the song, Lisa over there, she's about 22 or something, she doesn't know this song. She's like, Cliff Richard? No. Anyway, so, but there's no melody, there's no tune, there's no dots and kind of crotchets and minions and things, sorry Bob. And you just have to kind of be familiar with the song. The intro gives you 4 chords, F, D minor, G minor, C7, which is kind of like the chord progression that goes through it. But how quickly do we do it, and how quickly do we change? When we do the song itself, have a listen to this. The young 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 change. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 change. 1, 2, 3. So we kind of 8 beats of each chord. In the intro, we're going to do 4 beats. F, D minor, G minor, C7, the young one. Okay, so it's different. That's what we're going to do. So it's 4 beats, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then into verse 1, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, change chords. Okay? and we're doing a kind of calypso strum. Okay, from intro 2, 3, F, change. C7.
Darling, we're the young ones, and the young ones shouldn't be afraid to live, love, our fame is strong, 'cause we may not be the young ones very long.
The bit in the verse, like I said, the watch out for the strumming. Now, Alan's really good at this, so it's a good maxim in life to always watch Alan, whatever you're doing. Golf swing, ukulele strum, guitar, anything. Yeah. Dress sense, look at him, pretty snazzy. Got a joy jumper, look at that. Okay, so we're going we're all calypso. Tomorrow, it's all calypso. B minor, tomorrow, calypso. Back to F,
tomorrow.
Now this bit, pause, we're gonna go boom ba ba boom ba boom ba ba boom ba. Okay, just that. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna go the ba ba. So love me da da da, and then we just go back into the normal strumming. Okay, so love ba ba ba. See some ba 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 F calypso B flat. Okay, got it. So one more time that bit. So love me, F, calypso, there's a song to be sung, and the best time to sing it while we're... Okay, verse one, we'll do that, okay?
The young ones, calypso, and darling, we're the young ones, and the young ones shouldn't be afraid.
Get ready.
Strong, 'cause we may not be the only ones.
The shadows do a lot of things, Barry, that we're not going to mention tonight. Like little walks and things like that, which are pretty difficult when you play. Yeah. Okay, oh, we're already on song three. All Shook Up by Elvis Presley. Put your microphone on. That's not even pointing at you. Shame on you. You've been away for a few weeks, you need to get away with nonsense. Do you want to pass the magic mic to pass the magic mic to Mike?
Yes,
Mike. Mike on the mic. Right, let's have a cup of tea song. All Shook Up, songbook 6, page 3.
Tomorrow. That's why wait until tomorrow.
It's got a shuffle to it.
Wrong with me, I'm a man on the buzzing tree. My friends say I'm acting wide as a bug. I'm in love, I'm all sugar bomb. Oh yeah, yeah. Well, my hands are shaking, my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet. Now who do you think when you have such lovely love? I'm all sugar bomb.
Good Alan, and he still needs the songbook. Sit in there.
It's
not me.
I thought I had you, Barbara. Now, here's a little thing you can try if you want to get from the B flat to the C. It makes it more difficult, but it's nice if you want to do it sometimes. Just take your B flat, move it 2 frets, C, okay? And if you want, do it in stages, B flat, 1 fret, 2 frets. Okay, B flat, 1 fret, 2 frets. Like this. F, D minor, listen to this. Move it 1 fret, C, B flat, B, C. We're just doing 1 step, B flat, and C, 2 frets, dream, okay, 2, this is, dream, somewhat 9, page 3, 2, 3, 4, dream, quick thing on this song. We're going to do something adventurous here, just on that last song there. When we get to the last verse, this is a classic Westlife Boyzone moment where, and I'm sure the Everly Brothers will have done this, where they rise up from their stools, come to the front of the stage, and they modulate. Now that's not Rue Sharon, honestly. That's just where you, they just go up a key. They go up from F up to G, okay? Sandra was worried there was, wasn't she? So where we're gonna do that is this. I can make you mine, taste your lips wine, any time, night or day. The only trouble is, gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away. And then we're going to insert a different chord, and then we're going to modulate to the key of G. Now, John and Tony are at the front here. And if the fear has had their minds over the years, then we'll see if they... What is the name of the type of chord that we need when we get from one part to the other part? What do we call that?
A passing chord.
Very good. It's like a little bridge from one bit to another bit. A passing chord, a stepping stone chord. Okay. And if we want to modulate up to the key of G for the kind of I need you so, so we're doing this on the I'm dreaming my life C, then what we're going to change to that will allow us to pass and get to G. Tony can do this one. It was C and C7.
Someone's cousin or someone's auntie.
Somebody's cousin or auntie. Auntie chords are good. Very good. Well, if...
No clue.
That C at the end of the line, we're going to call it a turnaround chord, because that takes us and allows us to go back into F again normally. At the end of the chorus, I Can Make You Mine, we get a C, and that's our turnaround where we go back to F again. So if we instead want to jump not to F but to G, then that's C. We've got to have the equivalent chord from the key of what is it? D, Jonathan Bailey.
I'm just counting
up.
just
bring your chair and the table a little bit forward there. Hold on. A little bit ahead of John and Tony there. Yeah, D. D, because it's the equivalent chord from the key of G now. So we're gonna go only trouble, as I'm not a day. Only trouble is, gee whiz, dreaming my life a C. And then go to D, and then play a G, alright? And we don't need to do the whole of that bit. But you'll hear how it sounds. I'll keep going, you can keep going with this. Okay? So from the B flat, I Can Make You Mine. 1, 2, 3, B flat. Makes it very high actually, but it's good. So that's how I lift off our stools, walk to the front moment. You see Alan doing that. Just grab the microphone, walk to the front. Beautiful. Very good. Alright, number 5, Lean On Me, Bill Withers. In G, songbook 10, page 16. We did this one during lockdown because I think he passed away, didn't he? And so we did it that week as a little tribute. Maybe not a brilliant tribute, but I can get some royalties from it. This has got a bit of syncopation, a bit of rhythm to it as well, obviously. Thank you.
times in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong.
Songbook 7, page 18. Better with bass. Marion, it starts off with a G in brackets. What does that mean?
You don't have to play.
Yeah, you don't have to play it. And in this instance, Marion likes those chords, you don't have to play it on. In this instance, you don't play it, all right? We sing over it, but you need to know it's a G. But the key song's in our first strum. Oh, yeah. So that's the C there. But we start on a G. Oh, yeah. Okay, one, two. Oh yeah, I tell you something, I think you'll understand that I say that something, I wanna hold your hand, I wanna hold your hand, yeah, yeah, I wanna hold your hand, oh please, say to me, how could I get me? Your man, and please say to me, Nice, okay, good, thanks for that. Loaded question, because I asked Rob to ask this earlier. I didn't. Where are we going? From the G. Oh, yeah. So I'm doing this thing. I'm taking my G chord. Oh, please say to me. I'm trying to mimic this. That little riff, okay? The way I do it is I get my G. And I just go back a fret. G. Up a fret. A minor. And it's not quite right. But it's pretty much there, okay? G back, G up, A minor. Okay, do that with me. So it's G back, G up, A minor. Okay, so it's like second fret, first fret, second fret, third fret, A minor. One, two, three, four. G, da, 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 two, three, four. By the Eagles, didn't this very often, probably for good reason. Songbook 11, page 8. Oh yeah, I don't want that A chord to bat the bottom, sorry about that. Yeah, that's a jazz chord.
Love it.
Yeah. Desperado, Songbook 11, page 8. Now, Alan, play this with a bit of pathos, alright? Not too much, man. Just enough.
Desperado, why don't you come to your senses? You've been out riding fences for so long now. Oh, you're a hard one. I know that you've got your reasons. Those things that are pleasing can hurt you so. Draw the queen of diamonds, boy, she'll beat you. she's evil. You know the Queen of Hearts is always your best friend. Now it seems to me some fine things have been laid upon your table, but you only want the ones that you can get.
Meet me on the corner, songbook 1, page 21. into that Claire's hire tonight. We're stuck in a rut now. Good, good, good. All right. You know, we have you noticed we're missing? When I woke this morning, I was thinking about Graham on the kazoo and John on the harmonica. And I thought, because of where they live, we should call them the Ulverston Brass Section. You'll notice the Ulverston Brass Section, not here either of them. So I think Graham's a little under the weather, and John is not, actually. So there we are. And when you're an astute brass player like they are, part of the Ulverston Brass Section, then you have to have your lungs, kind of like clear and all that. So you've got a cough. You can't play that harmonica, that kazoo very long. So this is a shout out to the Ulverston Brass Section and the bass player Malcolm. We're looking forward to you all being back soon. Happy Together by the Turtles, Songbook 10, page 10. I don't know why I say that. Jonathan, is it annoying when I say Turtles? Yeah. That's right, I'll find something it does. Syncopated dance drums. Nice.
Imagine me and you. I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold you tight. I'm happy together. If I should call you up, you belong to me, to ease my mind. Imagine how the world would be, so very fine, so happy together. I can't see a lovely little body with you for all my life. When you're with me, the skies will be blue for all my life. Me and you and me. No matter how they toss the dice, it has to be the only one for you is you, and you for me, so happy together.
Ulverston Brass Section!
Malcolm
came up with that. He didn't write it, of course. He's not a terrific. That's all over the chorus, yeah. I should have made that clear at the beginning. So the kazoo is over the chorus, then the chorus is over the chorus, and then the ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba is over the chorus, yeah. Yeah. Because I noticed that, the third time we did the chorus, the ba-ba-ba-ba, some people were feeling a bit sheepish. Oh! Ba-ba-ba-ba. Yeah. Thank you very much. I'll be here all night. Good. Drive home safely. All right. Is this mic working? Yeah, the Wanderer. All right. C with a blues riff. confess. I tear up my shirt and show the rosy on my dust, 'cause I'm the wanderer, yeah, the wanderer. I roam around, 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 around. Well, I roam from town to town. If life without a care, I'm as happy as a clown. With my two bits of eyes, I'm going nowhere. I'm the type of guy who likes to roam around. I'm never in one place. I roam from town to town. But when I find myself, because I'm the wanderer, yeah, the wanderer. I roam around, 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 around. 'Cause I'm the wanderer, yeah, the wanderer. I roam around, 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 one more time. 'Cause I'm the wanderer, yeah, the wanderer. C7, so just 12 frets up.
Okay.
Yeah, so anything after the double dots, although I've got C as well, it starts again on C7. So it's C7.
Did you paint those marks on there?
No. Like
they're useful,
okay. Yeah, they are. Good, yeah. I got dots on the top, but yeah, it's the older, the falling leaf.
Okay.
Alright, now let's just swap it up a little bit for a little bit of a... This was one we did in lockdown. I remember, Di's not here, one of my neighbours, and we did the, I think when Virilin passed away, a lot of people passed away, didn't they? When Virilin passed away, and we were using this song already, were we not? And I remember out my road, set up a little PA system, did this, and the neighbours all joining in. It's not for a moment. It's a lovely moment. Check the chords. There's some kind of strange ones. E7th added fifth. It's an E7th, and just move your third finger into the third fret. Okay, you don't have to do that if you don't want to.
Thank you.
That E seventh handed fist, really nice, isn't it? That? You can use your little finger actually to do that one. It's not a diminished, it's nice. Alright, upside down, pull over faith. Songbook 5, page 16. Now, there's two versions of it, whatever you fancy. And just to say thanks for coming out tonight. So a few people are away ill. If you don't feel comfortable with being in a room like this with people, we need to keep the door open. We have the door closed tonight because it is getting colder and all that. But, you know, send me messages about it if you kind of like anxious, worried about any of it, or if you think there's anything you can do differently to make it better, you know, safer or whatever, etc., etc. Maybe Margaret, when you're doing the money, you could fever scan everyone on the way in and you know, check their vaccination certificates and take their temperature under their armpit and stuff.
Don't go that far.
Got my flu jab text message a couple of days ago, very good. Now we're going to do a stop and we're just going to sing the first line.
Angels watching over me with smiles upon their face, 'cause I have made it through this far in an unforgiving place. If sometimes it's just too steep for a boy like me to climb, but I must start those stops right now and do it in my own time. I don't care, I'm halfway there.
Living upside down. yourself. We're happy together, that's what it is. Hey, well done, everybody. Yeah. Listen, there's a gig coming up. There's two gigs coming up, actually.
Yeah.
If you want to, you don't have to, if you want to, we've got a gig, we've got an invite for after the Monday Plenkel fireworks on Saturday the 6th of November, in the George Pub, little performance there. So anyone that wants to come along and join in, I'll send out a set list. I sent out the Spond invites this week. You're like, oh, I'm not Spond against the guys. So have a little look at that. And but anyway, I'll send out the set list. If you want to come and join me at the Georgia, that'd be amazing. And then we've also got another gig. Yeah, in December. No, another one around. Oh yeah, Cabot Circus. Just like a couple of days later on the Tuesday, I think it is afternoon, leading up to Poppy Appeal. Or the Poppy Appeal. So that is. Let me just tell you now. It is Tuesday the 9th at 3 o'clock at Cabot Circus in Bristol. So again,
if you're up for it.
Tuesday afternoon. Oh no, wow. I'll just say priorities. Now we've got an invite for we've got a gig, definite, for December, the Stroke. I'm not going to say the whole name now, but the Stroke Support Group in Tilbury, our usual gig, that was good. But an invite for Mike, what did you say it was?
Memory Cafe.
Well, being ironic. Memory Cafe. And then Margaret's given me an invite for something as well.
For the Deaf Society.
Yes, amazing. The Deaf Society. Wow. Okay.
You'll feel the vibrations.
That's all good. Well, we'll work it out.
If you're deaf, you'll feel the vibrations.
No, you'll be right. Good. Hey, Zoom. Lovely. Thank you for joining us tonight, Zoom. Hope you've had fun. It's just Zoom. Everybody, is everyone on Zoom? Look. Woo! Just people on Zoom. Look, it's everybody. Yeah, lovely. Very good. Take care, Zoomers. See you soon. Take care. I'm going to leave John in charge. Joan. And YouTube. Thanks. It's been amazing tonight. I hope you've enjoyed it too. See you soon. See you next week. Here we go. Bye now. Bye now.